about sodium-ion battery. I love lithium-ion battery, but we should compare potassium, sodium, and lithium. And I believe we can have new insight to study three batteries. So I'm working with Tokyo University of Science, which is rather traditional in Japan, about more than 100 years old university. And it is the longest history among the scientific private university in Japan. And I want to emphasize my university is really related to battery. More than 1,100 years ago, an engineer and also he is alumnus of my university first developed dry cell based on the technique, based on the finding of French Leclanche wet cell. It was wet. It is not so convenient. So Mr. Sakizoyai is improved with starch glue-based gel electrolyte. So maybe it is first gel polymer battery in the world. And also, today my topic, sodium-ion battery. Sodium-ion battery is also first demonstrated in the world by our group. So this is my outline. And first, I will show you the toward sodium from lithium. Everybody knows that lithium and cobalt are rare metals. So this slide shows the concentration in crust of each element. Copper and cobalt are expensive and also rare elements, but we can notice that lithium is also rare metals. Please note that lithium is very inexpensive. So I think the ratio of cost of one lithium ion battery cell is 2 or 1% of lithium cost. It is not so huge, but the resource availability is limited. So we have to move on to sodium ion to realize large format batteries. And more importantly, not only lithium but also copper and cobalt should be replaced with manganese, titanium, and iron. So because of the we need attractive batteries, many researchers focusing on sodium-ion battery. This slide shows number of scientific papers and each year. And everybody noticed that the number of papers is drastically increasing after 2010. And one of the important papers is by Ismail Sadun in here, sodium-ion battery. In this generation, only just a few papers per year. And now we can find more than 100 papers, and maybe I expect more than 200 papers of sodium-ion battery in this year. And in last year, we have international symposium sodium-ion battery in Spain here, and it was just first symposium. I had a talk. And second symposium will be held in US, and third one is in Japan. It is one of the evidence of the active situation of the sodium-ion battery field. Because of many large amount of papers, we can find many, many materials which are reported, many researchers in the world. We can see many oxide, layered oxide, and also phosphate, sulfate, and bandate, and also electrolyte additive and binder also important, and negative electrodes, the material is very important. And one of the good news is we can replace copper foil for lithium ion, can be replaced with alumina in sodium case, because no electrochemical alloy formation between sodium and alumina. It is also advantageous to realize lighter battery because aluminum is light metal compared to copper. So first, I show the sodium-ion battery. Harvard Ionic Carrier, recently, many people focusing on next generation or beyond lithium batteries. It is electrochemical device, so we must move ions. In case of lithium and sodium and potassium, the ionic rate is like this. But the size is also important, but Lewis acidity, I mean the surface charge density, is more important to understand the diffusion and also solvation. We know that triethyl methyl ammonium is very fast diffusion in electric double layer capacitor. And also potassium ion is also faster diffusion compared to sodium and lithium, so that we need potassium hydroxide for alkaline batteries. In case of sodium, because of very fast diffusion in solid phase, everybody knows nacicon, sodium ion superconductor. And also generally, lithium conduction is so slow compared to sodium and potassium, and also barrier at the electrode, electrolyte interface is so large. And in case of magnesium, it should be very high motivation for largest high capacity battery. But in my personal opinion, because of larger density of charge, strong chromic restriction is one of major drawback to realize very good battery. Anyway, I believe the diffusivity is higher for sodium than lithium. And yesterday, my student, Mr. Hasegawa, reported potassium ion battery. I believe that potassium ion battery will show better radio capability than sodium. And also, we know that the atomic weight is very important. In case of sodium, almost three times heavier than lithium. In case of potassium, about six times. It is really disappointing. However, it is a little bit misleading. It is not metal battery, it is ion battery. In case of ion battery, yesterday we know that Dr. Yazami reported that this is discharge state. In case of assembled battery, no lithium, no sodium, no potassium, no magnesium in negative electrode. So we should compare not metallic atomic weight, but also formula weight of the positive electrode. So in case of iron phosphate, we can find only 12% weight gain. In case of potassium, only 20%, 25% compared to the difference of atomic weight. It is a little bit negligible, and also this difference will be dilute with negative electrode, electrolyte, and separate, and so on. And the safety issue. Every time someone asks me, sodium should be dangerous. I never agree. In the case of, everybody knows dendrite is very dangerous. In case of lithium, main melting point is about 200. So if dendrite between positive and negative electrode, it will be quite dangerous situation. However, in case of sodium and potassium, the melting point is below 100. So if start the dendrite short circuit, and we have heat generation by Joule heat, and then it should be melt less than 100. So I believe safety issue due to the dendrite is less remarkable in case of sodium or potassium. But we should note that sometimes safety depends on the oxygen evolution from positive electrode side. So this oxygen evolution depends on the material, positive electrode material. Everybody knows that lithium nickel oxide and lithium iron phosphate, quite a different safety issue. So that in case of sodium, quite similar situation. So among the practical rechargeable batteries, we know that lithium is best choice. I am not sure sodium is better or worse than lithium, but our target is comparable battery performance to lithium. So let me move on to each material. First one is negative electrode and also electrolyte solution.
This one is a little bit old paper reported by Jeff Dunn's group, and they reported the sodium insertion into hard carbons. The capacity is about 300 milliamps. Unfortunately, the cyclability is not sufficient. He showed only 3 cycles. No data after 4 cycles. And in case of hard carbon, we can insert and deinsert reversibly sodium ions. However, in case of graphite, usually no intercalation of sodium. And we checked the dependency of electrolyte solution. First, electrolyte solvent. And in case of dimethyl carbonate, we have irreversible capacity here. And in case of a propylene carbonate or a DEC diethyl carbonate solvent, we observe quite nice reversible capacity. And the vinyl carbonate is not so good additive for sodium ion battery. When we look at the cyclability, PC and ECDC mixture realize very nice, excellent cyclability. In case of EMC or DMC or binary carbonate, the cyclability is unsatisfactory to realize battery. Not only solvent, but also electrolyte salts and additive is very important. When we change into sodium hexafluorophosphate, improve the battery performance, and when we add fluoroethylene carbonate, we can also improve the battery performance. And when we use combination of fluoroethylene carbonate and hexafluorophosphate, we can achieve very nice cyclostability. And recently we are trying to find new hard carbon. And one of the examples is hard carbon prepared from sucrose, which is table sugar, common chemicals, and it was heat treated at 1300 in inert atmosphere. As you can see, we already realized 300 mAh with hard carbon, which is comparable to graphite lithium system. And we also tried to understand how to the mechanism of sodium insertion by diffraction and X-ray scattering, Raman, and also solid-state NMR for negative electrode material. And our conclusion is, first, sodium intercalated between graphene layers, and then the nanopores are filled with sodium atoms. And we have a question. The sodium cluster is metallic or not? And we performed sodium solid-state NMR, and our conclusion is quasi-metallic sodium cluster is not evidenced. It is different from lithium system. But this NMR spectra depends on the hard carbon, and we are now trying to understand in detail the phenomena. So I think it is still debatable. And in order to realize satisfactory cyclability, binder is also important. Polyvinylidene fluoride is not acceptable for the battery performance. And when we analyze this mechanism, we confirm the defluorination, I mean decomposition binder. On the other hand, polyacrylate, sodium acrylate, and carboxymethyl cellulose is quite suitable for realize good cyclability for hard carbon. So, carbon is good negative electrode, and next I show you the binder and sodium alloy electrode. We have studied lithium-ion battery, and we studied also silicon electrode, and we focusing on binder. In case of silicon graphite mixture electrode, polyvinylidene fluoride is not good binder. It is known generally. In case of polyacrylate, which is amorphous polymer, so that we can realize very thin and uniform coating of polymer. On the other hand, in case of PVD crystalline, so that not uniform coating. And by lithiation, we observe volume increase, and because of very nice coverage of binder, we can realize very nice reversibility. So binder is important in lithium-ion battery. Of course, in case of alloying electrode for sodium, binder is very important. This is one of example, tin sodium alloying. Of course, not only binder, but also electrolyte active is very important to realize the larger capacity and cyclability, and we observed 500 mAh. When we look at the periodic table, everybody noticed that alloying material are located in P block. And from phase diagram, silicon, tin, and phosphorus, antimony, they are potential candidate for alloying electrode. And our testing, tin is one of the best one. And we also checked the phosphorus. In case of phosphorus, powder phosphorus with polysodium acrylate binder, we observed quite large, huge capacity, about more than 2,000 mAh. So, not only our reports, but also many reports on the negative electrode, we summarize the energy density and the reversible capacity of sodium ion battery negative electrode. And we assume, by assuming the positive electrode, nickel, manganese, titanium, we just calculate energy density based on the only active material. We can see that hydrocarbon is here and the energy density is comparable to graphite spinel lithium cell. In case of higher capacity but a little bit elevated potential negative electrode, it seems to be good candidate for high capacity sodium ion, but not for high energy sodium ion, because the potential difference is quite important to determine the energy density. In case, for example, in case of phosphorus, it is huge capacity, more than 2,000, but the energy density is almost the same as tin electrode. The capacity is quite different, but potential at around 0.7 and also 0.5 or 0.4. This difference is quite important. So let's move on to the SEI and perturbation. So because of limitation of time, I just the conclusion of the SEI. In case of lithium, thicker, and we found many organic compounds on the surface of electrode. In case of sodium ion cell, SEI exists, but chemical composition is quite different from lithium. I mean, the surface is mainly consists of inorganic compound, and also the thickness is thinner than lithium. So next, I show you the positive electrode material. So because of recent years, many reports of positive electrode materials, we can summarize and we can find many positive electrode materials. And our group focusing on mainly layered oxide. So lithium cobalt oxide, it is quite famous material. And in case of sodium cobalt oxide, potential is lower. But everybody noticed that fully delithiated or fully desodiated phase, it is same compound, cobalt dioxide. So potential toward same direction. But in case of lithium and sodium occupied phase, we observe quite different potentials. And because larger ionic size, we observe many polymorphism of sodium cobaltate, like O3, P3, O2, and P2 phase. This slide shows just superimposed charge-discharge curve of O3, P2, P'3. It is surprising that this region, very similar charge-discharge curve. This is one of evidence of predominant effect is sodium-sodium interaction in the layered oxide. Because in case of sodium ion battery, element design is very important. Our maybe best and ideal target is sodium layered iron oxide. And it was reported by Japanese group Professor Okada about 10 years ago. It is so impressed me that sodium iron O2 works very well at 3.3 flat voltage. It is generally that lithium iron oxide never work based on iron 3 plus 4 plus redox. It is really motivated me to realize sodium ion battery. And unfortunately, in case of iron oxide, maybe it is very inexpensive. However, not so satisfactory battery performance, lower capacity. And in case of cobalt, it is well-known layered oxide and very good electronic conductivity, but many phase transition. In case of iron, no phase transition. So we tried to synthesize solid solution. One of the best way is one by one solid solution, iron cobalt oxide. And you can see here, capability so excellent. In spite of larger particle size, about 5 or 10 microns, I believe that this is due to the very fast diffusivity of solid sodium ion inside the electrode and also electrolyte solution. So it is just general that lithium is smaller than sodium, and in order to make deficient free layered oxide, this difference is quite important. On the other hand, we can say that cobalt and sodium very different ionic size, so that we can observe, realize very wide variety of crystal structure and also almost negligible crystal defects. And one of interesting feature is we can realize crystallized p2-type in case of sodium. We never direct synthesis. We never observe direct synthesis of lithium system in for the p2-type layer structure. And 2 years ago, we reported iron manganese layered oxide, p2-type structure oxide, and it shows about 200 mAh. And from Mesubawa and also X-ray absorption, we proved that iron redox reaction is 3 plus, 4 plus. And in order to higher capacity and also higher voltage, our present conclusion is necessary of nickel redox reaction in P2-type structure. And one of good candidate is nickel manganese titanium oxide. In case of only nickel and manganese, which was reported by Jeff Dunn, but the cyclability is not so good. And when we put smaller amount of titanium, we can stabilize the charge discharge. And from in-situ X-ray, in case of titanium free, the volume change is so significant. However, by titanium doping, we can suppress volume change. So, in case of 1-6 titanium doping, we can observe very satisfactory battery charge-discharge performance. And when we compare the many positive electrodes, we can understand that very high capacity or very high voltage, which is better for sodium ion battery. So this slide is just similar to negative electrode. And in case of higher capacity, we need higher potential to realize higher energy density. In case of titanium doped nickel manganese oxide, the capacity is not so high. However, the average potential operation voltage is rather high compared to other layered oxide, so that energy density is quite high. And also, in case of higher energy density, we can realize high power density with lower current density, so that high voltage operation is so suitable to obtain the higher power energy density. And one other candidate is iron nickel manganese oxide, as reported by my student, Mr. Hashimoto. I think these materials is a candidate for the high energy density sodium ion battery. So, finally, future aspects. sodium ion battery, just identical configuration to lithium ion. So the same manufacturing plant will be adapted to sodium ion battery. We need more money for new plant. We can, if we can have plant for lithium ion, we can also manufacture sodium ion. So this is very important merit for economy of production. And I believe lithium ion battery is best one because of lighter atomic weight. However, in case of sodium ion, lower cost and also very fast diffusivity. So in my opinion, two possibilities for the sodium ion. First one is high power battery, such as hybrid electric vehicle application. And the another one is stationary use for combined with wind, solar power, and so on. So recently, many people focusing beyond lithium ion, not only sodium, but also air, sulfur, magnesium, solid state, aluminum metal. So there are many candidates. So very good situation. However, not only cost, but also we need to consider manufacturability, productivity, and also battery performance. Actually, lead acid, very, very low energy density. However, we need to switch on engine of the any vehicles. So not only battery performance, but also any many factors are necessary to be considered the realized battery. And my last message, sodium ion. Is it really beyond lithium ion? I'm not sure. Some professor said to me, it is below lithium ion. Yes, sometimes correct, because heavier atomic weight. But in my opinion, and I believe, sodium ion should be beside lithium ion to design the next generation sodium ion battery. So conclusion, comparison lithium, sodium, and hopefully, and in future, potassium ion chemistry, crystallography, intercalation, diffusion, perturbation, solvation, kinetic, and some dynamic, we can realize better battery performance. So this is acknowledgement of our industrial partners and also financial support. And this is my colleague. And thank you for your attention.
Thank you.